cannot afford lawyers and transcripts, they would be provided free of charge. Do you have any questions?
No, I'd just like to say to your honor, I am not suicidal. That's what I would like to say.
Okay.
I am not suicidal.
Okay.
I am not suicidal. I am innocent, and I am not suicidal. If I did this, then it means that I stuck my fist in the fears of black Americans in this country for over 400 years and the fears of the LGBTQ community. Your Honor, I respect you and I respect the jury, but I did not do this. And I am not suicidal. And if anything happens to me when I go in there, I did not do it to myself. And you must all know that. I respect you, Your Honor. I respect your decision. Jail time. I am not suicidal.
Okay. Mr. Uche, let me inquire. Are there any post-sentencing... Sheriff, court is adjourned.
I am not suicidal.
Stop laughing at our class.
I am not suicidal. And I am innocent. I could have said that I was guilty a long time ago.
You can't make this shit up, you guys. This man said this after the judge spent a half hour going over all of the evidence, line by line, of the crimes and the lies and the perjury that this man committed. It is absolutely stunning how intractable a narcissist can be. This is what makes you crazy, is dealing with their delusions. And no matter what you say or do, they are going to stick to their fraudulent identity. It is amazing. So if preparing how to go up, over, around, and through these types of people to become and remain fully alive again sounds good to you, hit the subscribe button and let's do what we do and dive deep.
Years, no fears, fully alive again after these years.
A narcissist's main characteristic is entitlement. They honestly believe that they have a right to do whatever they want to. And whatever they do is justified. This is where they slip into delusion. Narcissists are 100% fraudulent. They are fake. What you just witnessed, in my opinion, is a malignant narcissist who refuses to deal with reality. And if you are consistently in the close proximity of one of these types of people, it can drive you insane. Slowly. I really mean this. When someone is telling you that up is down and down is up, and they're looking you dead in the eye and saying it with the utmost sincerity and purity and will not let it go, this is maddening and exhausting. And when we become exhausted, we don't think clearly. This is why we should never, ever argue with someone that we know is a narcissist. Studying these people for years, I would just sit back in conversations, and they had no clue that I knew they were a narcissist. That's how I studied them. And witness just how delusional these people are. And it is stunning. And Jesse gives us a chance to really witness this up close and personal. He honestly knows that he's lying. He knows that, without a doubt. But he also believes that he is entitled to lie, and that you, me, we should believe it. We are mandated to believe his lie because he's the almighty narcissist. And how dare you challenge my illusion? This is my make-believe world, and you are a part of it. And how dare you try to alter my altered state of being? This is my party, and I'll cry if I want to. I mean, this is crazy making 101. And this is why you have to be very careful of the woke community. Because in pop culture and throughout our society, for some reason, people think narcissists just come on the right wing side of things. A very conservative mindset. And this is foolishness and can walk you right into a lot of problems. Narcissists are everywhere, every shape, size, color, ethnicity, lifestyle, gender, you name it. And they are Luciferians of chaos. That's what you just witnessed, is a Luciferian of chaos. He does not care about all of the emotions and energies that he is stirring up throughout our communities, throughout the black community, throughout the gay community. All that matters is that you see him as a hero and or a victim. He kept stating, if I am not suicidal, if anything happens to me, I didn't do it. Now, is that a puerile mindset, thinking that somebody, there's a great plot to kill him, like he's such a international important human being with great information and connections that somebody's going to off him? Maybe. Could he be that type of person? Maybe. I don't know. But if I was a betting man on this situation, I would say it's his grandiose illusion about himself. And number two, that he's throwing up the victim card, that you guys should worry about me now that I'm going to jail. It's a mind game. He's laying mind bombs all over the place. And he wants you to view him as a victim and a hero simultaneously. I'm not suicidal. I'm a swell guy who's trying to defend black men. That kind of stuff infuriates me. The hubris stance that this man has, and playing on the years of suffering and the horrific legacy of the bondage that we African Americans have gone through in this country is nothing less than vulgar. I wish he'd have got more jail time. And I know some of you are like, no, he doesn't. He's Jesse. He doesn't deserve bullshit. If you piss on our legacy like that, you need to be held accountable. There are things you don't play with. But narcissists have no boundaries. And we just witnessed that. Now, his indetractable stance is evidence, tangible proof that you should never try to get your point across to a narcissist. It's over. It's done. We often want closure with these people, or we want an explanation, or we want them to make some kind of sense out of all of the horrific and vulgar things that they've done. You will never get that. And if you try to hold them accountable, especially to other people, they are not going to budge. So don't even try. These people love it. When there's chaos, there is not a name, not a statement that you can say to one of these people that will illuminate an opportunity and a choice to be honest, to take ownership of who and what they are. It is an utter, complete waste of time to try to make sense and conversate with the narcissist about any of their abuse, any of their lies. They are Luciferian agents of chaos. They cannot stand healthy, cohesive, harmonized environments. They hate healthy people and healthy things. This is why we cannot be healthy interacting with them. Let it go. When you know what you know, I don't care if the entire planet was telling me that I was wrong and the narcissist is right. I would not let go of the truth that I know. We know what these people are, and we know what they did to us. As long as you stay cognizant of that, you don't need to convince other people you are healthy. But the more we try to convince other people, and the more we try to convince a narcissist by communicating with them about anything, the more vulnerable and exposed we are. Let Jesse Smollett's energy be a lesson to never argue with a narcissist. Never seek sanity and information. It just isn't there, you guys. I chuckle because I've done that in the past. And I'm waiting for some kind of logical conversation with one of these beasts. And that's, if you see two people arguing 2 + 2 = 4, and one's arguing 2 + 2 = 37, and both of these people are in a heated debate, you are witnessing two fools there. Leave them in their delusion. They are completely fraudulent and intractable. And those two states of being are crazy-making formulas that will exhaust you and whittle you away. All right, you guys, this guy, this brother, come on, man. What are you, high? Are you high? So, the takeaway, you guys, a serious conversation with one of these people and trying to get information is redundant. Just walk away and let it go. I thank you guys for stopping by today. And what say you? What do you think of Jesse? Do you think he's innocent? Do you think that the system and the man is coming down on this brother? Let me know. What say you? All right, you guys, and I'll catch you on the next video.
No tears, no fears. Fully alive again after a piece of years.